Hey everyone, you're here with Mark and Sage here at Perfect Gardens TV. So today is going to be video two of our series on the bucket system. So a few weeks ago, I was thinking about the entire process of making lab, right? And the basic process is you wash rice, then you allow that rice to sit for 3 to 5 days, then you add anywhere from 10 to 20% rice water that's been sitting for 3 to 5 days. Then you add, like I said, 10 to 20% to milk. From there, you let that sit for 3 to 5 days. What ends up happening is you end up creating something called curd. And then you drain off basically the liquid. The curd separates to the top. There's a thin film of it at the bottom. And the stuff in the center is called lab. From there, you end up adding molasses to it or brown sugar on a 1-to-1 ratio. And then now you have a product called lab. When I was going through this entire process, I found a number of inefficiencies through this process. And I understand why. It's because, you know, you make a quart sized jar of this, that'll be enough for your garden for the season, depending upon the size of your garden. You know, there's no reason to make a large amount of this unless you're in some level of year round production of growing plants. And so when I started going through the process of making it internally for our own company, I started realizing, like, you know, this really should be something that I show other people how to make, and not just make it like how everyone else makes it, but make it more efficiently. And I started to think about the inefficiencies around this entire process. So some of the products that you're going to need through this entire process is going to be your bucket system. You're going to need a heat mat, I would recommend, some cheesecloth, a filter, a metal screen filter. I actually like using this because it has measurements on the side. It makes it easier for mixing your molasses, which is another product you'll end up needing, or brown sugar, drops of balance to treat the milk and the water, and some rice. And you can use a pipette as well. And I highly recommend that if you have kids to, you know, teach them how to do this entire process, because I will appreciate it later in their life. Some of the first inefficiencies around making this, as I see other people do, is a lot of people will tell you to use your tap water, but let it sit or off gas for 24 hours at least before you use it, and it'll work just fine. Yes, that's true. Yes, it's going to work. What's going to happen is the chloramines and the other toxins in the water, over time, the bacteria will strengthen. The bacteria will hyperaccumulate these heavy metals or these toxins. Then the bacteria will begin to become dominant in your environment. That's all great, but the issue though is you still do have these toxins in your water, and it does slow down the bacterial growth. Same thing that actually goes with your milk. A lot of people use milk, even if it just comes straight from the cow. You are still dealing with the antibiotics that were used to keep the plant healthy at one point in their lives, or maybe the type of feed that the animals are getting. Maybe the feed is under-mineralized, which I can almost guarantee you it is. So then the feed is deficient, right, in some level. Then if it's deficient, then the cattle's deficient. Then the milk's going to be deficient because it's going to be missing the coenzymes that bacteria need to actually produce enzymes. It's the same thing in our gut biology, what our gut biology needs. It needs coenzymes. And what are those coenzymes? Coenzymes are trace minerals. And that's why drops of balance is so essential through this entire process, because drops of balance, it cleans water, it remediates pesticides, fungicides, so heavy metals, all these things that actually slows the speed at which the bacteria travel. And when it slows down the speed, it obviously the bacteria produce enzymes less efficiently. Then what happens is drops of balance leaves behind 100 trace minerals. So now you're stacking the x-axis, for example, of the coenzymes that bacteria need. And then when you produce your own lab, now you're stacking the bacteria on the bottom, because it's not just one bacteria that comes off of rice. Bacteria are all over the place. They're floating in our air. They're when we touch something, it's on our hands. And bacteria are essential for growth, right? But bacteria are only one part around the 24 hours of mag production cycle. It is also coenzymes are trace minerals. So what we do is we take a gallon of treated tap water at a rate of 5 mL per gallon. So we treat it with drops of balance at 5 mL per gallon with the hottest tap water that comes out of our faucet. Then the following day after the water is cooled, because we normally treat our water at night, and I would normally end up adding 2 cups to 3 cups of rice for every gallon of water. And I make it really easy. I don't mess with the rice at all. I throw the rice in a gallon container. I shake it up. I screen it. So that now I have my rice left over, and now I have the washed rice and the water. So from here, you're not gonna wanna cap this. You're actually just gonna wanna put like a towel over it and let it sit in a closet for 3 to 5 days. And after 3 to 5 days, you should start to smell some type of a nice, beautiful sourdough smell. Then after that, I will purchase 3 gallons of milk. From here, you're gonna be treating your milk with 5 mL per gallon of drops of balance. So I'll put in 3 gallons of milk in there. And then I'll put a little less than a half a gallon of the rice water that has been sitting for 3 to 5 days. Then I end up putting a heat mat on the bottom of the bucket with a thin towel over it. And the heat mat takes the temperature of the water over a course of 3 days up to around 80 degrees. And from there, you end up having this beautifully caked layer of curd at the top, which you're able to literally just drain all of your lab out from your faucet. At that point, in other videos, we're going to get into learning to make cheese with this curd, actually. But from here, after you take the material that has drained off, you will then mix it with a 1-to-1 ratio of unsulfured molasses or brown sugar with your lab. What I will recommend to do also after this is allow your lab that has now have 1-to-1 ratio with molasses to sit in a closed container for about 3 weeks. What's going to happen there is all the alcohol should get burnt off basically, and it should turn into vinegar. So what you end up having is you have now you're doing multiple things. You're using your product as a pH down because it's vinegar. I mean, anyone that uses apple cider vinegar has their pH down. They don't have to do that anymore because now you have vinegar. And you also have your suspended lab, right? Your bacteria that is in a dormant state because of the sugar. And what happens when you add the sugar in, you basically remove the concentration between sugar and water equalizes basically. So that bacteria goes dormant. And actually I can get into the science of that later. It's actually kind of interesting because you could actually take this product and turn it into rum. If you leave the container open versus closed, it turns into a different product. Yeah, in later videos, we'll start to break down what other byproducts can come from making this. I hope you enjoyed the video.